Let's talk about roles and centers in NetSuite. First, roles. What is a role? According to Suite Answers, a role is a defined access configuration that can be assigned to users. In other words, each standard role has specific access permissions and restrictions automatically built into it. Keep in mind that roles are different from users. One user could be assigned to any number of roles. There are several standard roles NetSuite provides. To see the standard roles available to your company, navigate to Setup, Users Roles, Manage Roles. On this page, you will see both standard and custom roles. Standard roles include things like AP and AR clerk, accountant, bookkeeper, CEO, developer, retail clerk, and warehouse manager, to name a few. When a user logs in with any one of these roles, he would have access to everything permitted for that role. The most powerful role is the administrator role. Any user logged in as the administrator would have unlimited access to all the data in their instance of NetSuite, including all the records, reports, and transactions. This individual also has the ability to access and customize roles for other users. If you are logged in as the administrator and would like to customize a role, you can do so on the Manage Roles page. Find the standard role that you wish to customize and click Customize under the Edit column. On this page, you can name your custom role and then proceed to customize the permissions and restrictions. You could also create a new role from scratch by navigating to Setup, Users Roles, Manage Roles, New. However, creating a new role this way would be tedious and is not advisable. Since one user may have access to multiple roles at once, it's helpful for each user to be able to set a default role. The default role would be the user's primary role, and this would be the role NetSuite would log them in as. To set a default role, click your name in the upper right-hand corner of NetSuite. On the My Roles page, you will see all the roles you have access to. To change the default role, hover over the three dots to the right of your preferred role and click Make Default. Being able to set a default role can save you a lot of time, but sometimes you just need to toggle quickly between roles. To do that, simply hover over your name in the upper right-hand corner of the screen and select the role you need to view. If you leave NetSuite while logged into one of your non-default roles and then log back in later, NetSuite will automatically bring up your default role. So where do centers come in? According to Suite Answers, each role is tied to a center, meaning a set of tabbed pages that display as the NetSuite user interface. A role center determines the pages that users see when they log into NetSuite. In other words, different roles have different centers, different tabs that appear when a user logs in as that role. NetSuite comes with several standard centers that organize the NetSuite user interface in a logical way to supply the information that each role would need. These centers include the Classic Center, Accounting Center, Sales Center, Employee Center, Support Center, and Vendor Center, to name a few. As with the roles, you can also create your own custom centers, which you can use for any custom roles. To create a new center, navigate to Customization, Centers and Tabs, Centers, New. On this page, label your custom center and choose an optional ID. To decide which tabs will appear on your new center, you need to create new tabs and directly apply those tabs to the new center. To create new tabs, navigate to Customization, Centers and Tabs, Center Tabs, New. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by hitting the like button. And to learn more about how SuiteRep can help you with all of your NetSuite needs, visit us at SuiteRep.com.